Yes. We've gathered together in your presence. Holy Spirit, do what the Lord Jesus has sent you to do in this place. Father, we just want to thank you for each one of us. We want to thank you for your presence.
Hallelujah.
We want to thank you for your love.
Yes, Lord.
And we want to thank you for the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
That is in this place.
Hallelujah.
Be glorified and be magnified. Lord, touch my lips that I speak that which is of the Holy Spirit. Take away the mind of man, but let only the mind of God speak to us today. Do a new thing in my life. Do a new thing in my brother and my sister, that together we are going to conquer. Thank you, Lord, for you are a good God. Be you glorified and be you magnified. We appreciate you, Lord, and we know that you are the Alpha and Omega. You are the end of everything we need. Be glorified in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Our God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And I just want to thank God for the Spirit of God in this place. And I just want to appreciate God from the bottom of my heart. And I want to thank God for the man of God. Kitts Green, evangelist and Pastor Beata, you're doing a very great work here. We thank God for your lives, and we pray that your labor was going very. God will remember you for the great work you're doing in His kingdom. Praise be to God.
Amen.
This is our first Sunday meeting together in 2017 as Weapons of Revival, both Perry Bar and Kitts Green, and we just want to thank God for the Spirit. That God is going to guide us and lead us this year in a very special way. Because He is God. He is not a sound of a human man. He is God. When God says a blessing, He blesses you. All He waits is for us to just take our position.
Hallelujah.
And I believe this year God is doing a new thing. And I'm persuaded about what I'm saying, because I've seen the Lord many times in my prayer time. And in a personal study, I've seen God speaking to me as a man speaking to a man. And I'm so persuaded we're in the right direction and we're in the divine order of God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. We just want to just thank God for this year. It's a very special year. God is ready to equip us, and He can make us become overcomers, and we are true ambassadors in His work. And I just want to just encourage you to be ready for 2017, because God is doing a new thing.
Hallelujah.
God is ready to use people who are ready.
Amen.
Just put yourself in mind for God to do a new thing. Let's quickly go to the book of Genesis chapter 8, Genesis chapter 8, there's one scripture which was not on my diary for the teaching, but I'll use that just to just make mention of this month again, because some of the things that I'll mention here by the grace of God in Peribah, I've already mentioned them, but I feel led by the Spirit to just enlighten them. So that together we move with the direction of God. Genesis chapter 8 from verse 1, the Bible says, "And God remembered Noah and every living thing and all animals that were with him in the ark. And God made a wind to pass over the earth, and the waters subsided. The fountains of the deep and the windows of heavens were also stopped, and the rains from heavens were restrained. And the waters receded continually from the earth. And at the end of 150 days, the waters decreased. Then the ark rested in the seventh month and the 17th day of that month." I want you to mark those two dates. In the seventh month, the water, the Bible says the ark rested in the seventh month, which means there was a continual coming of rains. Disaster kept coming, but on the seventh month, they began to see hope for the remnant, which is the number of completion. Praise be to God. And the Bible says on the 17th day of that month, that's when the ark rested. And the 10th month of the first day of the month, the tops of the mountains were seen. In the 10th month of the first day of the month, they began to see the tops of the mountain. Which means, you see two numbers there. You see number 10 and number 17. That's where everything was concluded. So, biblically, number 17 is a very significant number. It's a number where they saw God overcoming for them. It's a number where they saw the victory of God. It's a number where they saw the waters that were, they were getting ready to swallow the people. We saw the waters where we seen the enemies were defeated. What the enemy thought of. They saw on the 17th day of the month number 10, they saw that now everything has abated. And then hope was there finally. So you can see that God works in number. He is a very numerical God. He honors number, and numbers are very significant to us today. And if we move with the Spirit of God, we're going to see that the year 2017 is a year where God wants us to overcome total victory, to overcome our enemies, to overcome every delaying spirit, to overcome every non-achieving spirit, so that God will bring us to a place of total settlement and influence. Because He is God. And He's not a son of man who will speak a word today and tomorrow they will change their statement. When God says, I'm blessing you, God blesses you. He is God. That's His nature. When God says, be you holy, He's holy Himself. That's why He says, I have edified my word above my name. Hallelujah. He does something in His divinity that allows even God Himself to submit to His word. So as long as you and me begin to stand on the word of God, we're just like there. We can do anything that God can do, and we can have anything that God can have. That's the ability. And this bodes well with the message the man of God spoke today about being led by the Spirit. So you can see that, you know, we know the story of Noah. We started learning from Sunday school. It's a very familiar story. We're told that Noah obeyed God in times where people were disobedient, people were merrymaking, they were enjoying, they were doing all sorts, but Noah responded to the kingdom call. And he reasoned to God and built an ark. And I believe in 2017, God is looking for a church that is going to submit to His word and respond to the kingdom call. So I just wanted to enlighten you from there that 2017 is a very symbolical year. It's a year where God expects us to overcome and overcome our enemy and see the complete victory that God has set aside for us. For example, like in Kitts Green, you're equipping, God is equipping you to become ambassadors. Amen. I believe every Christian is being equipped to become an ambassador. But if I'm to be a true ambassador out there, number one, I need to have my ID. I need to know myself. Who am I before God?
Amen.
Hallelujah. The problem with many Christians today, we don't know ourselves. God has given everything to us, but up until you and me know ourselves, know who we are in God.
Hallelujah.
Know your spot where you are. That's why in Birmingham, we're standing on locating your position. We know our theme as a church is a year of equip and overcome. But as a church in Birmingham, we believe in God that everybody in 2017, they're going to know their spot.
Amen.
They're going to locate their position. You know, we pray prayer sometimes and say, may the Lord locate you. It's very true, God is going to locate you, but up until you locate yourself first,
amen,
then the location of God will be easy. Amen. Because God may locate me as pastor, but if I don't know my position as a pastor, it will just be a name on me. But God has created us as a people who are supposed to stand out and change something and influence something. Praise be to God. So in your own personal study, go home and look at the book of Genesis 8, that where God spoke to me so much about the theme that we're having this year. So, let's continue on where we with our teaching today. Let's go to the book of
The book of Ephesians chapter 4. Praise God.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4. Are we there? Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Verse 8, the Bible says, therefore he says, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive and he gave gifts to men. Glory to God. Then in verse 11, the Bible says that he himself gave some to be apostles, some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be pastors and teachers, for the equipping of the saints, for the work of the ministry, and for the edifying of the body of Christ.
Amen.
And verse 13 says, until we all come to the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man and to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we should no longer be children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the trickery of men, in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting, but speak the truth in love, that we may grow up in all things and into him who is the head, Christ. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Now, I want us to understand that God is God by himself.
Amen.
He's a God that who keeps his word. And the moment we're going to stand up and begin to respond to the word of God, all what God does is to come in and begin to back up his word. Praise be to God.
Hallelujah.
Apostle Paul is revealing something very significant in the book of Ephesians chapter 4. He's giving us the reason why God had to distribute ministries to the people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because if we're going to overcome in 2017, you've got to be ready to be equipped by God. You've got to be ready to be empowered to be perfected by the word of God, to be ushered into that office so that you're ready, you're fully equipped. For example, I cannot go to a combat zone if I'm not ready to fight. Amen. If I'm not ready to do the work that a soldier do, because we are the soldiers of Christ. But if you look at the Bible in the book of Ephesians chapter 11, the man of God reveals that God gave some to be apostles. My question is, do we see ourselves as apostles? Some to be prophets. Do we see ourselves to be prophets? Some to be evangelists. Do we see ourselves? Because the first and foremost we need to do is to identify ourselves who we are. Who am I? Do we see ourselves as pastors and teachers? Now, if you read this book carefully on your own, you find that there are three key areas. The first portion, God is giving offices to people. Praise be to God.
Amen.
God is giving offices to people. And if you look at an apostle, it's not even a strange word. It's just special messengers or representatives of God. Glory be to God. God is giving assignment to people to be special messengers, to be representative. They can represent God at a level that will change people and bring people to the knowledge of God. Look at a prophet, it's just a person who speaks a new message to you. If, for example, you're there, you're just in a situation, you don't know how to come out or to do, then somebody drops a word that you say, oh God, this is what I wanted.
Amen.
That's prophecy. God has, somebody has dropped a new message to you. If you look at an evangelist, somebody who will spread the good news for observation, somebody will go out there. Like I've been speaking to my brother who's doing the camera, he's got the passion to go out there and just bring souls to the body of Christ. Doesn't it matter who would go there and bring that salvation to people? You talk about pastors and teachers, these are shepherds, people God has guided and instructed, they will go and guide people and instruct people to come to the knowledge of the word of God. So God has done that, he's equipping us, because you see, if really I want to be a true ambassador, not just by a level, but a practical ambassador, I've got to be equipped.
Amen.
I've got to be ready. And as a church, we've got to be ready that God will equip us so that this year we're going to make some significant value, some significant movement. We're going to move to another level, bring somebody to a place where God wants them to be. So you see, God is distributing them offices so that we can be fully equipped. Praise be to God.
Then in verse 12 and 13, God is giving a target.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
He's giving a target. And this is what he says. He says, verse 12 says, for the equipping of the saints. Why is he giving those offices? For the equipping of the saints, and for the work of the ministry, and for the edifying of the body of Christ. He gives three targets. Target number one, he wants believers to be equipped. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He wants believers to be prepared for the work so that they become true ambassadors. People can stand and represent the government of God somewhere at a certain level. Glory be to God. Then target number two, he says, for the work of the ministry. Because if we to serve your man of God in Kitts Green, your man of God in Periba, you've got to be prepared for work. Because if you're not equipped to even just be an usher, if you're not equipped to usher, you can't usher. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Then he brings target number three, says, for the edifying of the body. That's the least way Christ came. Christ came to bring us to a place of hope. For the edifying of the body of Christ, for the comforting, for the encouraging. So you can encourage somebody. You bring the message of hope in the life of somebody. Hallelujah. He says, for the equipping of the saints, and for the edifying of the body of Christ, and for the work of the ministry. Hallelujah. Then from verse 14, God gives the reason why he's done that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, so that we should no longer be children. Amen. You know, it's possible to be in God for 5 years and remain a child. Amen.
Hallelujah.
He says, so that we should no longer be children. Amen. Before he gives that target, he says, until we come to the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
Until we come to the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God. So God knows that in order for us to have knowledge, to have wisdom, he says, until we get there. So God is giving this ministry, until we come to the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
Then verse 14, he gives us the reason that we should no longer be children who are tossed to and fro, carried away by every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men, in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting, but speaking the truth in love, that we may grow up in all things in him who is head, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So he gives reason that we should no longer be children, that we should no longer be tossed to and fro, until we no longer get carried away by every wind and doctrine, by the trickery of men, in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting. So you can see that God's main idea, God's main reason, is for us to grow up spiritually. Praise be to God. We have money to nourish our bodies and grow, but we are struggling to nourish our spiritual man to grow. Glory be to God. Do you know, there is striking similarities, the way God operates and the way the physical man operates. There are three stages of natural development. There is a babyhood stage, and there is a childhood stage, and there is a manhood stage. The same thing with God. There is a babyhood stage. That's why Apostle Peter, he spoke in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. He says, as newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word of God. Glory be to God. You know, every year, when I'm locating my position in God, I put myself at a baby stage. Amen. I don't over-exaggerate things. I don't put myself at a teenager stage. Whenever I'm starting the year as a person, my wife is my witness, I always put myself at a baby stage. And I level everywhere I want to grow. I want to develop. I want to get to a place of influence. I want to do something. And I put myself, I locate my position, and I put myself at a very stage. I desire the milk, the sincere milk of the word of God. Because I know that's where we start. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. God has given the reason. He says, you know, if we remain children in the things of God, we can be moved by every doctrine. Hallelujah. When God is bringing something to usher us into a place of God, or a place of influence, something will look like a test because we are still children.